Koti Chandra Sushitala Nitai Padakamala Koti Chandra Sushitala Je Chayae Jagat Jurae Je Chayae Heno Nitai Vine Bhai Radha Krishna Paite Nai Heno Nitai Vine Bhai Radha Krishna Paite Nai Drid Kuri Dharo Nitai Re Pai Dhid kori dhurunitai re paai Se sambandh nahi jaro Vritha janma gilotaro Se sambandh nahi jaro Vritha janma gilotaro Sei Pashu Boro Durachara Sei Pashu Nitai na bolilo mukhe Majilo samsara sukhe Nitai na bolilo mukhe Majilo samsara sukhe Vidyakule ki kori betara Vidyakule ki kori betara Ahankare mat huya Nitai pad pasariya Ahankare mat huya Nitai pad pasariya Asatyera satya kuri mani Asatyera satya kuri mani Nitair koruna hobe Braje Radha Krishna pabe Nitair koruna hobe Braje Radha Krishna pabe Dharo Nitai charana dukhani Dharo Nitai charana dukhani Nitai re charan satya Tahara sevaka nitya Nitai re charan satya Tahara sevaka nitya Nitai pada sada kuru asha Nitai pada sada kuru asha Narottama bodo dukhi Nitai more koro sukhi Narottama bodo dukhi Nitai more koro sukhi Rakho ranga charaner paasa Ranga charaner paasa Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare Hare Jaya Nityananda Rai, 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 Nityananda Rai, Jaya Nityananda Rai, Jaya Gauranitai, 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 Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai, 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 Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada,
Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, Prabhupada,
Prabhupada, Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Jaya Gurudev, 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 Jaya Jaya Gurudev,
Jaya Gurudev,
Gurudev, Jaya Jaya Gurudev. We'll sing the Mangalacharan prayers and then try to speak something on Lord Nityananda. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kada Mayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavanscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitanscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagat Pate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhyayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Nabaum Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyatya Deshatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaurabhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, these days of festival, they are specially very, very important for us as practicing devotees. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in a song, he says that Madhav Tithi Bhakti Janani Jatane Palana Kuri, that the days of appearance of the Lord or Ekadashi, these are very, very auspicious, and if we celebrate it for the pleasure of the Lord in the right mood, then just as a mother gives birth to child, so these days they can give birth to devotion in our hearts. So we should do it in a mood of service. Before we came to Krishna consciousness, you know how people celebrate Christmas or Diwali. Their mood is how I can buy so many things, how I can dress myself very nicely, how I can eat myself, you know, nice things. And they never think of the Lord on whose glorification or on whose remembrance these festivals are. But when we come to Krishna consciousness, we realize that our position is that of a servant. Our pleasure, the greatest pleasure we get is by giving pleasure to the Supreme Lord. That is the inherent nature of the jiva. Jivir swarup hoy Krishner nitya das. So Lord Nityananda, he is none other than Lord Balram. Narottam Das Thakur says, Brajendra Nandan jai sachisuta hoilo sai Balaram hoilo nitai. That Brajendra Nandan is Krishna. He came as Lord Krishna, as Lord Gauranga, and Lord Balram, he came as Nityananda. So before we go into pastimes of any personality, we should know who he is, what is the position of that person. We should know the tattva of that person. For example, in Geet Govinda, which Jayadev Goswami has written, he describes many, many intimate pastimes of Radha Krishna. But before doing all that, he establishes what is the position of Krishna. That Keshavadhrita Kurma Sarira, Keshavadhrita Meena Sarira, Jai Jagadishare. So he establishes what is the position of Krishna, that he is the source of all incarnations. So similarly, before we get into pastimes of Lord Nityananda, we should understand who Lord Nityananda is, why is it important for us to worship Lord Nityananda, then we can understand his pastimes better. Because many times when we read the pastimes, it can be, especially that of Lord Nityananda, it can bewilder you. The way he acted sometimes, it may bewilder you. So we should understand who the person is. Then we won't misunderstand the pastimes. So as we mentioned that Lord Nityananda, he is non-different from Lord Balram. Lord Nityananda, he was born in year 1474 in a village called Ekchakra in Bengal, and his parents were Hadai Pandit Ujha and Padmavati. Now Lord doesn't take birth as mere mortals like us do by conception of male and female, but Lord appears by his own sweet will. Just as, you know, suppose Prime Minister, he visits a jail sometimes. The jail people should not think that he is one of us, you know, because he comes by his own free will and he can go out by his own free will. Others can't do that. So Lord Nityananda, from his very childhood, he was always absorbed in his childhood games. Were what he used to do is he didn't used to play cricket or soccer or, you know, any other games. His pastime when he was a child was just to enact the pastimes of Lord Krishna in his different incarnations. So he would sometimes act as Lord Krishna dancing on the hoods of Kaliya, or he would enact the pastimes of killing of Putana or Shakatasura or the various demons, or sometimes he would act as Lord Varahadev, sometimes as Lord Ram and Lakshman, like that. And as a small child, everybody would wonder, like, how come he knows all these things? We never taught him. And they would ask him, who has taught you all this? And he would smile and he would say, these are my pastimes. And, you know, people thought he is just making it up. So he grew up like that. From his very, very childhood, he would be absorbed in the pastimes, in enacting pastimes of Lord, which reminded him of Supreme Lord. So that is the mood of Lord Balram or Lord Nitya and Lord Nityananda, that they're immersed. Lord Nityananda is the supreme, we say his, Lord Balram is the supreme personality of servitor Godhead. Lord Balram, he renders service in all different rasas in the spiritual world. So the spiritual planets, the Vaikunthas and Golok Vrindavan, they are themselves expansions of Lord Balram. So the whole spiritual world is expansion of Lord Balram. And then Lord Balram also expands himself. He serves Krishna by becoming his clothes, by becoming his shoes, by becoming his ornaments, like that. And Lord Balram also, of course, serves him as a friend, as a servant, as a elder. And he also expands as Anang Manjari to serve him in conjugal mood as well. So the mood of Lord Balram is to serve Krishna in various ways. And Lord Nityananda, he would also, he is like the supreme personification of love of God. He would be, he is known as Avdhuta. He, Avdhuta means a person who is, you know, he doesn't follow social norms. Avadhuta means somebody who is, Ava means who is far, Dhuta means taking bath. So a person who is Avdhuta, he doesn't even bother to, you know, perform. He's so absorbed, he doesn't want to waste a single moment in any other activity besides devotional service. Just thinking of the Lord or speaking about him. So that person is called Avadhut. And we have examples that in Srimad Bhagavatam, that we find example of Shukdev Goswami, who as soon as he was born, he left the home and he left his parents and Vyasdev was running after him. And he didn't wear any clothes because he was not in the bodily consciousness that I'm this body. All of us think that we are these bodies. But a person who is self-realized, who is a real Avdhuta, he knows that I'm not this body, I'm the spirit soul. I'm eternal servant of the Lord. So he is not bothered about the bodily necessities. And he doesn't, his vision is not of differentiating also anyone. His vision is he sees everybody as a spiritual spark of Lord Krishna. Like Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, that one who is self-realized, he sees the elephant or brahmana on the same level, because he is seeing the spirit within the body. He is not seeing the external body. Then we also have example of Bharat Maharaj, of Jad Bharat, that how he was totally absorbed in thinking of Krishna, and he didn't associate with normal people. Normal people thought that he is like a dumb person, he doesn't speak much, he doesn't understand, but he was the highest, he was in the highest ecstasy. So Lord Balram, he is oblivious to the, Lord Nityananda, he is totally oblivious to the external environment. He would go in this kind of ecstasies where he would be totally immersed in thinking of the Supreme Lord. And he didn't follow the usual etiquette which normal people would expect a person to follow. But what we can learn, we have a lot to learn from how Lord Nityananda, he teaches by his example. Now, as I mentioned before, that the why we suffer in this world, the basic cause of suffering is our forgetfulness of our real swarup, of our real position. All of us have come to this material world with the mood of being the enjoyer, that we are the center of the universe. If we look at our own lives, we are interested in those activities where we think, you know, what's in it for me, what I will get out of this, what enjoyment I will gain out of this relationship or from this thing. So we put ourselves in the center. But the real position of the spirit soul is to be servant of the Lord. That's the natural position of the soul. And to teach us how to serve the Lord, Lord has some, he has to descend himself to teach us that. We can't learn it by ourselves. Our service is very, very motivated, whether it's at work or whether it's at with family or, I mean, any walks of life, either it's personal sense gratification or extended self gratification. It may be for the nation, for the society, for it may expand like that, but it's not selfless. And Lord Nityananda, he teaches us how to be a perfect servant. Although he is none other than Lord Balram, who is non-different from Lord Krishna. It is said that the only difference between Lord Balram and Lord Krishna is their color. Lord Krishna is blackish and Balramji is whitish in complexion. But they are both Vishnu Tattva, they are both equally powerful. But Lord Nityananda, he teaches us how to be perfect servant. Before that, I want to mention very, very important thing is why worshipping Lord Nityananda is so important. Vrindavan Das Thakur mentions that there are 2 days in the year which are very, very important for us. One is Gaur Purnima and one is Nityananda Trayodashi. Why it is important is because only by mercy of Lord Nityananda we can understand Lord Chaitanya. And by their mercy we can understand Radha Krishna. Understanding Radha Krishna is not so easy. And Krishna is not, we know that Lord Gauranga, he is more merciful than Krishna. And Lord Nityananda, he is even more merciful than Lord Chaitanya. And we see examples of many devotees who got mercy or by whose mercy we know anything about Lord Chaitanya. They first got the mercy of Lord Nityananda. For example, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Vrindavandas Thakur, Lochandas Thakur, these are the three biographers of Lord Chaitanya who wrote different books depicting the pastimes of Lord, where they describe the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya. So, Lord, for example, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he composed the Chaitanya Charitamrit, which Srila Prabhupada translated. So, he first got the mercy of Lord Nityananda. Lord Nityananda came in a vision to him and he told him that you go to Vrindavan and all your desires will be fulfilled. He told him, Are are Krishna Das, na karaho bhai, Vrindavane yaha, taha sarval labhya hoy. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, then he found, when he went to, he immediately left for Vrindavan. And there he found shelter of all the Goswamis, like Raghunath Das Goswami, Roop Goswami, Sanatan Goswami. And he also got the mercy of Radha Govindji and Radha Madan Mohan. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he mentions specific verses in the fifth chapter of Adi Leela expressing his gratitude to Lord Nityananda. He says, Jaya Jaya Nityananda, Jaya Kripa Moy, Yaha Haite Painu Rupa Sanatana Ashray. That it's only by Nityananda mercy, Lord Nityananda's mercy, that I got the shelter of Rupa and Sanatana. Shishi Radha Landeshwar Bhagwan ki jaya, Shishi Jagannar Paldev Sudra Mai ki jaya, Shishi Gaur Nithai ki jaya, Giriraj Godhan ki jaya, Srila Prabhupada ji ki jaya. He also mentioned, Krishnadas Kaviraj also mentions, that Se Vaishnaver Padrenu Tarapada Chaya Adhamayar Dila Prabhu Nityananda Dayamaya. That I got the mercy of all the devotees in Vrindavan by mercy of Lord Nityananda. And so that's Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. Similarly, Vrindavandas Thakur, he was the last disciple of Lord Nityananda and he wrote the Chaitanya Bhagavat. And all the chapters of Chaitanya Bhagavat, they end with these lines. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Nityananda Chand Jan Vrindavan Das Tachu Pada Yuge Kan. That Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda, they are the merciful moons and their lotus feet are my heart and soul. And whatever I am writing, that is for that's an offering at their lotus feet. Similarly, Lochandas Thakur, who is another biographer of Lord Chaitanya, he wrote a book called Chaitanya Mangala, and he has written many wonderful songs like Nitai Guna Mani Amar, or Param Karuna Pahudujana, or Akuradha Paramananda Nityananda Rai. So all these songs, they were composed by Lochandas Thakur. So he also expresses his gratitude. So if these devotees had not got the mercy of Lord Nityananda, they wouldn't have written any of these biographies and we wouldn't have access to all these pastimes of Lord Chaitanya. Similarly, we read about how Raghunath Das Goswami, you know, he was the son of a great zamindar who had incomes of lakhs of gold coins. And that's not in today's state, that's more than 550 years back, which was a lot of money. And he was the only son of his parents and his uncle as well. I mean, he was the only boy in that family. Here to the such a large amount of wealth. But he wanted to surrender himself utterly at the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya. And he tried to on many occasions he would try to run away from his home. But his father had put guards, 10 guards, to make sure that he doesn't run away to Jagannath Puri from Bengal to Lord Chaitanya. And he tried many times unsuccessfully like this. And then ultimately when he got the mercy of Lord Nityananda, then he was able to escape from his home and take shelter. And he became the servant of Sarup Damodar Goswami, who was a very intimate associate of Lord Chaitanya. He got such personal service to Lord Chaitanya, and that was all because of Lord Nityananda's mercy. So we see that without mercy of Lord Nityananda, it's not possible for us to get shelter of Lord Chaitanya. Besides that, you know, there are other devotees as well, like Narottam Das Thakur, who were inspired by Lord Nityananda and who went, Narottam Das Thakur went to Padma River where Lord Chaitanya had deposited love of God, And by bathing in the river by Nityananda Prabhu's inspiration, he became a very, very great devotee. So in our lives as well, we can't directly jump to Lord Chaitanya or to Radha Krishna without going through the mercy of Guru Parampara and Lord Nityananda. And as I was mentioning earlier, Lord Nityananda, he shows us how to serve the Lord. Lord Nityananda himself is a very, very perfect servant. Now, let's see the activities of Lord Nityananda. Lord Nityananda was born 12 years prior to the appearance of Lord Chaitanya in this world. So, as I mentioned, he was born in 1474. So, he was doing all these childhood pastimes, and he was the only son of Hadai Pandit and Padmavati. But as soon as Lord Chaitanya appeared in this world, Lord Nityananda, he knew that I have a mission to accomplish it in this world. So, at the age of 12 years, he enacted a pastime in such a way that he left his home. There was a sannyasi who came to Ek Chakra, and he stayed at their place, and Hadai Pandit would discuss pastimes of Krishna with this sannyasi. And as a matter of, generally when a saintly person comes, when the person is leaving, that what, please tell me, what can I do for you? So as the sannyasi was leaving, so Hadai Pandit, as a matter of etiquette, he asked him, what can I do for you? All my wealth, all my family is at your lotus feet. Please order me, what can I do for you? And the sannyasi, he said, please give me your son Nithai. I travel around and I need a servant who can help me with the daily chores. So that was like a thunderbolt for Hadai Pandit and Padmavati. But they had the integrity. People in the past, they had the integrity that whatever word they gave, however hard it was to follow, they would, if they committed something, they would follow it. They won't go back. So Hadai Pandit, he remembered like how when Vishwamitra Muni had come to Maharaj Dashrath, and he had asked Dashrath Maharaj that please send Ram, Lord Ram, with me. And Dashrath Maharaj was so attached to Lord Ram, and Lord Ram was very young at the time. He was 11, and he told at that time, to Vishwamitra Muni, I can give you all the armies, I can give you everything, but don't take Lord Ram. But still, he carried with his promise, and he gave Lord Ram to Vishwamitra Muni. So similarly, Hadai Pandit, he didn't go back on his word. Although Lord Nityananda was dear most to his life, he couldn't live without him. And so Nityananda Prabhu, knowing that, although he knew that it will be very, very difficult for his parents to live without him, but he knew that I have to assist Lord Chaitanya. That's a bigger mission than, staying at home and pleasing my parents. So he left, he enacted all this, he arranged all these things to happen, and then he left with this sannyasi. And Hadai Pandit was very, very heartbroken, and very soon he left back. They are, of course, eternal associates of the Lord, so they went back to both his parents, they went back to Godhead. And Lord Nityananda, he traveled around. Now, Lord Chaitanya, in his initial years, he didn't show his ecstasies of devotion. He would rather act as like an ordinary grammarian, you know, and he was a great scholar anyway. So he would tease the devotees, and he was not propagating at that time. He appeared more like a, you know, atheist, or he was not definitely not a devotee at that time. But when he went, we know that Lord Chaitanya, he went to Gaya and he performed the Shraddh of his father, and then he met Ishwarpuri. And at that time, when he took initiation from Ishwarpuri, at that time he started exhibiting his devotion, his devotional activities, his purpose of coming to this world of propagating the Sankirtan movement. So that was much later. So Lord Nityananda, he was waiting for Lord Chaitanya all these years. So Lord Nityananda, he waited 20 years till Lord Chaitanya started the Sankirtan movement. He didn't preach. He was traveling to all the holy places throughout India, but he didn't preach to anyone about devotion until he got the order from Lord Chaitanya that you go and preach. So until we get, you know, blessings of our seniors that you go and preach, or you go and do this activity, we don't, you know, go ahead and do things on our own. So Lord Nityananda, although he is like embodiment of love of God, and we'll see by how just later on, how just by his glance, he would glance at people, the people would become devotees, they would be surcharged with devotion. But he didn't do any of this preaching activity until Lord Chaitanya started the Sankirtan movement, and until Lord Chaitanya gave him the order. Other thing our servant should know is the mood of the master. So one thing is that we should not act without getting instructions from higher ups. And second thing, what Lord Nityananda teaches us by his example is, for the service of Lord or Guru, we should be prepared to make any kind of sacrifice. Just as Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, when Lord Nityananda told him that he came in a vision and told him that you go to Vrindavan. So immediately when he woke up, he left for Vrindavan. He didn't stay behind to divide his, you know, wealth among his family, that I'll make a fixed deposit for you so that you can get interest, and, you know, I'll leave so much money for this. He immediately left for Vrindavan as soon as he woke up. He didn't even bother to that how I'm going to, you know, survive on the way. And he was not a young man at that time. He was quite old. So Lord Nityananda, he, for the sake of service to the Lord, he left his home. He was ready to sacrifice anything, and he didn't start preaching until he got the order from Lord Chaitanya. Then third thing Lord Nityananda teaches us is to understand the inner mood of the master. So after Lord Chaitanya took sannyas at Katwa, Lord Chaitanya, he wanted to go to Vrindavan. Lord Chaitanya, when he took initiation from Ishwarpuri himself, when he was a grihastha, he, at that time when he was returning from Gaya to Navadvip, at that time itself he wanted to go to Vrindavan. But at that time all the devatas, they reminded that, oh Lord, you have descended to this world to preach the glories, your glories, and make everybody devotee. So you should do that now. So once Lord Chaitanya, he took sannyas, he was again, you know, he was, of course, Lord Chaitanya, we know, he is tasting the love of, he's in the mood of Radharani, tasting the love for Krishna. So again he wanted to go to Vrindavan. But we find that Lord Nityananda and Lord Chaitanya, again he was not in external consciousness, he was just walking. As soon as he took sannyas with some of the associates like Lord Nityananda and Mukunda Dat, Jagdanand Pandit and others, and they were and Lord Nityananda, he tricked Lord Chaitanya to come back to Shantipur where Advaita Acharya was, because he knew that when Lord Chaitanya, he took sannyas, all the devotees in Navadvip were heartbroken. Lord Chaitanya, he left his young wife behind and his very, very old mother, Sachi Mata. So Sachi Mata and Vishnu Priya, they didn't have any, anybody to take care of them. But Lord Chaitanya, he took sannyas because many people were becoming envious, and he knew that if I take sannyas, everybody respects a sannyasi. So even those people who are envious, like the Brahmanas, they were complaining to Kazi and all that. So he thought that if I take sannyas, these people, they will respect me, and by that they will be delivered. So Lord Chaitanya took sannyas. But it was very, very difficult for all the devotees, and of course for Sachi Mata and Vishnu Priya. And when Lord Chaitanya was on his way to Vrindavan, Lord Nityananda could understand that these devotees, they will not survive if they don't see Lord Chaitanya. So he tricked, he told the cowherd boys who were there in that area that if Lord Chaitanya asks which is the way to Vrindavan, instead of telling him the way to Vrindavan, tell him the way to the Ganges. And so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was walking in ecstasy of a madman, totally absorbed in thoughts of Krishna. And then he asked these boys, who were cowherd boys, that which is the way to Vrindavan, and they directed him towards the Ganges. And when he went to Ganges, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he started taking bath, and he saw that, Advaita Acharya is coming here. Because Lord Nityananda, he had already sent a message to Shantipur, to Advaita Acharya, that you should come with a set of clothes for Lord Chaitanya. And you should also, he also sent a message to Navadvip, to Sachi Mata and other devotees, that Lord Chaitanya will be soon coming to Shantipur. So it was Lord Nityananda, although he arranged for Lord Chaitanya to come back to Shantipur. And it's in Shantipur that Sachi Mata, she requested Lord Chaitanya that please stay in Jagannathpuri. If you go to Vrindavan, it's very, very far. I will never get news of you. And if you stay in Jagannathpuri, then devotees from Bengal, they can go to Jagannathpuri regularly, and I will get news of you. So Lord Nityananda, he knew that inner mood of Lord Chaitanya, that Lord Chaitanya loves his devotees, and Lord Chaitanya, although he wants to taste the love of Krishna, but more than that is his love for his own devotees. Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Lord. He is not concerned about his own happiness. He is concerned more about the happiness of his devotees. That's the mood of Lord. Even when Lord Chaitanya was, actually when he later on went in Vrindavan, went to Vrindavan, he was there for 2 months, and there was he took a servant with him whose name was Balbhadra Bhattacharya. So Lord Chaitanya, he had burning desire for so many years to go to Vrindavan. So he wanted to stay there for a longer period. He didn't want to return immediately to Jagannath Puri. But Balbhadra Bhattacharya, he told Lord Chaitanya that I am miserable here. And he told that, you know, every morning you are absorbed in your ecstasies. But what happens is, as soon as I wake up, there's like a, you know, crowd of people who want to invite you for prasad to their home. And all of them, they eat my head. So I am in total misery since morning, you know, I'm just busy handling all these people. So let's, oh Lord, please let's go back to Jagannath Puri via the way of Ganga. So even though the Lord didn't want to return to Jagannath Puri, but keeping his own pleasure aside, just to please his servant Jagannath, this Balbhadra Bhattacharya, he said, okay, we'll leave today. And they left. So Lord Nityananda, knowing the inner mood of his master, he arranged so that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could go back to Shantipur, where the devotees could again see him. And ultimately, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he stayed at Jagannath Puri. So the amazing thing is, all us conditioned souls, we think we want to become the master. But see the mood of the associates of Mahaprabhu, like Nityananda Prabhu or Advaita Acharya. Srila Advaita Acharya is also he is also Mahavishnu, and Nityananda Prabhu is, of course, he is Vishnu Tattva, he is first expansion of Lord Krishna. But they all want to become the servant of the Lord. So Advaita Acharya says, Chaitanyara Das Mui Chaitanyara Das. Chaitanyara Das Mui Daser Anudas. That I am servant of Lord Chaitanya, I am servant of Lord Chaitanya. I am the servant of Lord Chaitanya. And Nityananda Prabhu also has the same mood. Ehi Rupe, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, he writes in Chaitanya Charitamrita that Ehi Rupe Nityananda Ananta Prakash Sei Bhave Kohe Mui Chaitanyara Das. So Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, he goes in great detail describing that how from Balram, you know, the first Chaturvyuh comes, and from that Chaturvyuh another Chaturvyuh comes, and then how, you know, all this Mahavishnu comes, Garbhodakshai Vishnu comes. All these are expansions of expansions of expansions of Lord Balram. But Lord Balram, he wants to take the position of servant of the Lord. So that is something we need to learn. So ultimately, when Lord Nityananda, you know, because he is omniscient, he realized that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has started the Sankirtan movement, so he came to Navdvip. And they had a wonderful, and he didn't tell anybody. Lord Chaitanya, he got a dream in which he told his devotees that yesterday I had a dream in which I saw a very magnificent chariot, and there was a great personality on it, and there was a flag of palm tree, and this personality was holding a club in one hand, and he stopped in front of, and he was saying, is this the house of Nimai Pandit? Is this the house of Nimai Pandit? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that definitely some great personality has come to Navdvip. And he sent Srivas Thakur and Haridas Thakur to search throughout Navdvip. And he described how this personality looks, that he is very tall and very powerful and dressed in blue. But they couldn't find Nityananda Prabhu anywhere. And then after 9 hours, after they searched for 9 hours in Navdeep, they came back and they said, you know, we've searched everywhere, we searched in the marketplaces, checked on the ghats, we have asked people if such and such person has come, but we couldn't find anybody. And then Lord Chaitanya said, I will take you to the place where he is hiding. And Nityananda Prabhu, he was staying at a devotee's place, I think it was Nandanacharya, and he was sitting calmly, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he went, and everybody saw Lord Nityananda was sitting there. And there the two lords met. So I'm going to go into details of their meeting, but again, you know, in a few days' time, I think it was next day, they arranged for Vyas Puja of Nityananda Prabhu. And Nityananda Prabhu, as I mentioned, he was always in the mood of, he was always in the ecstasy of serving the Lord, about thinking of the Lord. So Shivas Pandit, he arranged all the paraphernalia, and the time came when he had to put garland on Vyasdev. Nityananda Prabhu had to put garland on Vyasdev. So Shivas Pandit, he kept on telling, he handed the garland to Nityananda Prabhu and he said, please put the garland on Vyasdev. And he said, so be it. Nityananda Prabhu said, kept saying so be it, but he kept holding the garland. He didn't put it on Vyasdev. And Srivas Thakur, he tried few times, and then he went to Lord Chaitanya and he said, you know, Lord, you please go and tell him. He keeps saying, you know, so be it, but he doesn't put the garland, and the time is, the tithis will go. And then Lord Chaitanya came to Lord Nityananda and he said, please put the garland on Vyasdev, Nitai. And immediately Nityananda Prabhu put the garland on Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because he said, you are my Vyasdev. So he is always in the mood of servant. Now most important is the supreme mercy of Lord Nityananda. We find that Lord Nityananda has other incarnations, when he comes as Lord Balram or when he comes as Lakshman, he does get angry. We find that Lord Balram, but of course he has that childish innocence. We know that Lord Balram, he wanted to marry Subhadra to son of Duryodhan, you know. He's so innocent, like a crooked person like Duryodhan. But Balram, you know, he even made Duryodhan his disciple. He taught him all. He didn't discriminate whether he is like a crooked person or he is a pious person. Balramji is very, very, you know, very, very merciful. So, but Lord Balram, you know, there was a past time when Lord Krishna's son, Samba, he wanted to marry Lakshmana. Lakshmana was one of the daughters of Duryodhan. Samba wanted to marry her, but the Kurus, they were against that. So at that time, you know, Balramji went to make up and beg the Kuru. He went to Hastinapur to request the Kurus that please hand over Lakshmana and let the marriage happen. And at that time, the Kurus, they became very, very angry. They said, you know, you Yadus, who are you? Your position is because of us. The Kurus are so powerful, you know. Your position is like that of a crow who wants to eat, from the plate of Brahmana, like that. And Balramji was like this. Duryodhan was, you know, vilifying Lord Balram, and he was vilifying the Yadus. Balramji was patiently listening, but his anger was growing every moment. And he became really, really angry. And he said, you know, you're forgetting your position. And Lord Balram just took his plow and with one blow into the earth, he started dragging the whole Hastinapur into River Ganges. At that time, the Kurus, they came to senses and they started begging, and then they started glorifying Balram that we forgot your position. So Balramji, he used to get angry. Then we find that how when Romaharshan Sutta, he didn't get up when Lord Balram went to Naimisharanya. Romaharshan Sutta, he was sitting on the Vyasasana, and when Lord Balram came, everybody stood up respect of Lord Balram. But Romaharshan Sutta, he kept sitting. So at that time, Lord Balram told that, you know, this person is very learned, but he doesn't know what is the essence of Vedas. Romaharshan Sutta, he was a direct disciple of Vyasadeva. Romaharshan Sutta, it's already time. So Lord Balram, anyway, he killed Romaharshan Sutta just with a straw. Shishi Radha Lanneshu Bhagavan ki jai. Shishi Jagannath Swami Sudra Mahiran ki jai. Shishi Govindar ki jai. So I'll just finish in 5 minutes, if it's okay with everybody. Let me just finish the point I was making. So Lord Balram, he killed this Romaharshan Sutta with a blade of grass. Now when this Lord Balram, he comes as Lord Nityananda, he puts this blade of grass in his mouth and he is falling at the feet of all the conditioned jivas and requesting them that please take the name of Lord Krishna. Bhaja Gauranga, Kaho Gauranga, Leho Gaurangera Namare. So Sei Jana Gauranga Bhaji Sei Mera Mura Pranare. So that Nityananda Prabhu is so supremely merciful that he exhibited such anger in his previous incarnations. But even at the cost of being nearly killed by Jagai and Madhai, he gave the love of God to them. So Nityananda Prabhu is supremely merciful. And Lochandas Thakur says that Emon to dayalu nai mar khai prende. Who can be more merciful than Nityananda, that who even after being nearly killed, who gave the mercy? And if such a person, if you don't worship such a person, then you are you're less than an animal. Lochan bole, sei papi elu ar gelo. That such a, only a very, very sinful person will not worship such a supremely magnanimous personality. And he just lives in vain in this world. So thank you very much for your kind attention. I just got carried away and had to describe many pastimes. Shishi Lord Nityananda ki jai. Nityananda Rai ki jai.